So this is the high-res digital file that we got for Blade Runner. It's a 24-bit, 88.2 kilohertz sampling rate. You can see just by looking at the waveform that it's very, very wide dynamic range. It goes from extremely quiet down in these areas to these big peaks that you can see throughout the score. And that's just much wider dynamic range than you typically see on any kind of recording today. There's absolutely no wavetop clipping. They haven't really compressed it in the digital domain at all.
Enhanced 15 to 23.
And then the other interesting thing, which I'll show you once we get it playing here, I have a spectrum analyzer built into the console that shows you how much information there is from the lowest bass to highest treble. The lowest rung on this spectrum analyzer is 25 hertz, and this lights it up pretty good. And you don't see that very much even on classical music. It's not uncommon to see 32 hertz, but 25 hertz is really getting down there. And let me just zoom in here. Because of the wide dynamic range, you don't really see the whole display lit up all at the same time, because it's only when the peaks happen that they come up. But coming up right now, you'll see this is 25 hertz down here, and it jumps quite high, quite often, and that'll really give your subwoofer at home a workout when you play this back. And we didn't filter any of this off on the vinyl. What's on the score is on the vinyl. In the old days, when we were worried about skipping on cheap record players, it was an issue, but tried it on two or three turntables and it played, so we went with it. And it's just kind of an ambient thing. It just sort of rumbles and goes, but it's a very important part of the music. It creates the mood, it creates the tension. Now you can see it there.
All those moments will be lost in time.